Hello everyone, welcome to a new Legacy video where I keep on playing some War of the Sparks Legacy because there's a lot of new cards, and once again we see Narset and Teferi, but this time it's not in a control deck, this is in show and tell. We want to see how Teferi is shutting off your opponent interacting with you. It's gonna be in a deck with a show and tell shell. Since we're playing Teferi, you can't really play sneak attack. So we're doing it in an Omniscience version with the Cunning Wish. And since we get access to white, we're gonna also try Monastery Mentor too, you know? So I see if Monastery Mentor, just turn one Monastery Mentor, post cyber opponent can just, you know, not really see it coming. It's also one main deck, kind of like a B plan. I also want to try Narset. The original list was playing 4 Teferi. I decided to go 2+1 in the sideboard, just because I think Narset still is actually pretty good at shutting off a lot of decks in Legacy. So Teferi, Narset, and then the classic combo of just show and tell, put into play Omniscience, and then either just Emrakul or just go Cunning Wish to just dig for Refinement Foresight, release the ends, and just win the game in a classic way. If you don't know what it is, it's just a very obscure way to just win the game, but that's not gonna be a big deal. Once you have show and tell in play, you just win the game. Then we have Ponder, Brainstorm. We don't have priority, we have double impulse, which it's a 2-drop for Fireman Foresight, which needs you to grab requires you to have 2 mana instants, and impulse, it's a pretty good card. It just digs well, very well deep. And then Intuition to both, like, is a 3-drop of Fireman Foresight to get, you know, more Cunning Wish. And I guess you can just get Cunning Wish. Intuition can just get your show and tells and so on and so forth. So decklist pretty easy. There could be a basic planes in the deck, but I prefer just a, you know, regular fetch lands. This list comes from EW Landon, who 5-0'd with this deck. So yeah, obviously I always take decks that are somewhat, you know, that did somewhat well. All right, let's change the Purge since I really don't like textless card. I don't understand why I print them in the first place. I think you should always be able to read every card, and, you know, seeing textless card just kind of makes me, you know, unhappy for opponent. Let's say, like, for example, like, let's say you don't know what Chessel Purge is, and your opponent just play a textless card, textless version of it. It's pretty bad. All right, what do we have? Disenchant, Monastery Mentor. I think, like, against decks like Miracles, I have, like, a lot of different plans, as you see here. We have Bozeju, which is mixed uncounterable with Show and Tell, so you just win because you go Show and Tell Omniscience. It's another way to just go Teferi. Maybe Bozeju is a little bit too much, but I kind of expect Miracles to be quite popular with, like, this new standard. Sorry, this new Legacy, I don't know if it's a standard. So we have a lot of various ways to attack the matchup. We have Monastery Mentor, we have Teferi, Show and Tell, and we have Bozeju. I don't really know how to sideboard in that matchup. We're gonna navigate through it maybe later. And then we have a lot of just instances to get with your Cunning Wish. 4 mana for side and release the answer just wins the game. Rushing River, in case you need some interaction as well. More Intuitions, just to, in case you go, like, for a Cunning Wish for value. Intuition is usually the best, since then that can get either your Omniscience or Show and Tell. Counterspelling Flusterstorm, since we're playing 4 Spell Pierce main. We're playing Spell Pierce over Flusterstorm main right now because of Chalice and Planeswalkers. 3 Line of Sanctity, that's for the Hype to Direct decks. And then, Purge and Disenchant as more instants to get with your Cunning Wish. So yeah, that's the deck. Let's head down to a Legacy Competitive League. And I remind you that this is ChannelFireball.com, so please head to their website to see all the new cool new cards that you want to purchase. First round, we are on the play, and I'm gonna keep this hand. It's a little land heavy. I mean, it's a 5-land 2 spell, basically. That's what it is. But Lotus Petal can just make us so that if this Ponder gives you 2 good cards, we just go off next turn. All right, and Ponder does give us 2 pretty good cards. I mean, I'm gonna put them like this. I'm gonna pass the turn here. And, alright, planes into Aether Vial. Alright. I'm just gonna bounce it, I believe. Kind of added, I'd have to shuffle that intuition on top of my deck, though. I probably don't care. Yeah, I'm gonna actually just save my second Lotus Petal. I think I'll put it into play. So I'm playing the Teferi here, bouncing the Vial. drawing a card and passing the turn. And then next, so if they play Thalia, which is like their best card, and one of the reasons why we could have slow rolled is the Teferi. Ancient Tomb, wow. What is this? Revoker. I was gonna shut off my Teferi. Or maybe Petal, I don't know, honestly. It's fine. I think that probably should shut off Petal because they can attack the Teferi. They do shut off the Teferi. Alright, it's fine. Then now I'm happy I didn't plus it. Okay, let's play Ponder Brainstorm first. If I find what I want to find, I can just win the game. I don't find what I want to find. So I'm gonna put this back. Play land and pass the turn. Cunning Wish can get me Intuition. Or it can get me Disenchant. I don't particularly love Disenchant right now. I should honestly just keep Cunning Wish in my hand, I think. I mean, I could go Cunning Wish for Intuition. Then if I draw Omniscience, I still go have Show and Tell plus Show and Tell Omniscience Intuition to win. Whereas if I don't, I can just Intuition for Omniscience. So I think I'm gonna go for that. I'm gonna cast Cunning Wish for Intuition here. And this is just a play that I just love to make a lot. So whether they're attacking me or Teferi. I think Teferi makes sense in case I just deal with this Revoker. I don't have my Planeswalker in play. Alright, do they have another Vial? That's fine. So they don't have a report. They pass the turn. Wow, okay. I'm gonna get another Plains here. That might have Wasteland, you know? And I don't care about white. Also, I have another Fetch in my hand. And I'm gonna go Cunning Wish. For Intuition, as I said. Yes. And then I'll untap, hoping to draw a Omniscience. I draw a fourth petal. I've been drawing a lot of petals here. I'll just play land. And I think I'll play petal as well, and then I'll pass. I could art cast force of will if needed. Or if nothing happens, I can just go Intuitions for Omniscience. And then I just have a Chantel for Omniscience. I don't have a way to win with it, but you know, then. Then you can just draw literally anything and win. It's pretty cool how this version is much better against White Weenie, against Death and Taxes, than the version with Sneak Attack. It's like, Caracas is very good against the version with Sneak Attack, but it's not good against this version, because we have Omniscience to just, you know, we don't care about Caracas with Omniscience in play. Right, there is Caracas. A tougher version of it. Pretty cool picture. So as that was JIT, I'm not gonna force it. They try to race me now before I can hit my combo. And as you see now, the Cunning Wish for Intuition into Omnitell, it's like, into Omniscience, it's like a fine play. It's pretty slow, but I think it works. So here I go to 16, the JIT gets countered. And I'm looking to draw just like either Cunning Wish or, I mean, even Emrakul or just cantrips now. I don't want to draw Omniscience now anymore. So I'm going to Intuition, target them, get three Omniscience. Alright, what's this? Thalia. That's weird. I should have definitely main phased the Thalia there. Alright. So we're going to take Omniscience. And done. And now we just wait to draw. I could even, no, I don't want to crack this petal up Delta, because if I draw Brainstorm, I might just use the petal to cast this Show and Tell so that I have a Brainstorm at the ready with a counter, with a fetch land up. Actually, Brainstorm costs one mana now because of Thalia. So I just want to draw, I guess I just want to draw Emrakul. That's like the best draw, because Emrakul is free, because it doesn't cost one more. Remember, even if there's an Omniscience in play, you have to play one more no matter what. And since we have to pay one more no matter what, I think all I want to do is just casting Show and Tell now. And then I have a Omniscience in play, and I can just art cast Force for free. So play Show and Tell. I don't think this helps them in any way. They could have like Flicker Wisp, that's like the only thing that they can do. But a Flicker Wisp doesn't do anything now. And there's no way they can interact with my Omniscience main deck. Because usually, you know, Council Judgment is in the sideboard. Like this play post sideboard isn't that good. Right, they go Seraphanger, which they couldn't have played, so I guess they got a help there. And I want to play an Ancient Tomb. I guess I do not. If I drop Brainstorm, I might need cards in my hand. So now my opponent has 4 plus 5. Yeah, I have just one turn to win the game. But you know, I did get a lot of deep in my deck, and it's fine if I miss. I mean, that's just a combo deck. You can't fizzle. So this is 6 plus 5. It's 11 damage coming across. And yeah, I mean, might even be an Emrakul is not enough. So I just have like 3 Cunning Wishes now, even though I have a lot of cantrip. I also do have, you know, lands and counters and Teferi to draw. I could draw Narset. Definitely get deeper to find combo pieces. Alright, so what do they do now? They have one card. You said it? Okay. So we need to draw now something. Come on, something. And there it is. So we cast Emrakul. We take an extra turn, we draw another card. Opponent should not bounce the Emrakul with Caracas. And I'm gonna keep on top this. I'm not gonna play this Ancient Tomb. So I'm gonna get an extra turn. And then what? Let's see. I draw Ponder, so I'll play with Omniscience, but I have to pay 1. They're on 16. Yeah, whatever. Let's just get that Cunning Wish. Alright, I got a Narset. I think that's fine. I think Narset is good here, so I'm gonna just shuffle library, nope. Then do I want to shuffle? The top two cards are pretty bad. And I'm looking for Cunning Wish. If I shuffle, I go down to 8. So this turn, if I attack, my opponent could just sacrifice like lands. And then they have lethal. And not block, and then they have lethal. They can also just gain life. So Emrakul does not do too much. It was just a time walk. So I'm just looking to draw that. Alright, so let's play this with Omniscience. Minus 2. And we find that Cunning Wish. But what does Cunning Wish do right now? So we have Ancient Tomb, so we have a lot of spells. So we could go Cunning Wish for the combo right now involving Release the Ants takes a while to win. So right now we can cast 4 spells because we have Ancient Tomb. So that's 4 mana. So I can go Cunning Wish, Ancient Tomb Cunning Wish. So the combo with Release the Ants just deals, it's pretty weird that we don't have. So I could cast Rushing Reaver, Kicker. And then return 2 permanents. What can I return? I can return like Sarah Vanger and like Revoker. This is a funny game over here. Just trying to navigate this the best as I can. So if I bounce something like Jit, maybe I should bounce like Jit. And this doesn't trample, funnily enough. So I can bounce Jit and Saravanger. Or maybe I can bounce Thalia. What happens if I bounce Thalia? Can they they can replay it immediately because they're Vile. So what happens here is I bounce Jit. And I bounce like Sarah Vanger. So this sacrifice a land, return target non-permanent land. I can bounce Jit and I can bounce Caracas maybe. Then I attack with Emrakul. I just let it through down to 1. But then I don't die on the backswing, and then I still have an Emrakul in play. You know? And I have a Force of Will for the Jit. So I think my play here is Cunning Wish. Cast with Omniscience. Yeah, I just need to bounce that Jit. I could even do it at instant speed, honestly. Because, you know, it's an instant. Return target no longer permanent to its owner end. If so, kick, return another permanent. So, yes, I think that's the... That is my line. I don't even need the Ancient Tomb. Because I just need a Cunning Wish and the Rushing River. I guess I should also need... Force of Will maybe, so losing 2 life here could be relevant. It's funny that we're thinking so long about this game. Let's just do this first. Let's just go to combat, because I need to attack in order to win. Did I reveal the Cunning Wish? Yes, I did. Alright, so let's attack here. Once I know what those I sacrifice for the Annihilator, I can know better what to bounce. Or I can even just bounce main phase. You know, if they keep Wasteland, I can just play Ancient Tomb Pass. There's a bunch of options now. They obviously don't know what I have exactly. I can also just release the Ants them if they take 15. They're on 16. Oh, actually, they have Jit, so never mind. They are on 20. So yeah, this is a pretty long combo game. All right, they're sacrificing Thalia. If they do sacrifice Thalia, I guess they can have another one, right? I guess they can have another one. All right, so they don't have Wasteland anymore. So I'm just gonna play Ancient Tomb and passing the turn here. And then I can just go Cunning Wish for either Disenchant or Rushing River or whatever. It's lucky that they have Thalia. So I'm just gonna play Ancient Tomb and pass. This is all instant. Cunning Wish, release the Ant, Fireman Foresight. Yeah, I can all do an instant speed in response to them violating Thalia. Alright, I go Wasteland. They kill that. So guess I'm going to just tap this now. I don't care about if I lose 2 life. Actually, what I'm talking about, this is free. So I'm casting this with Omniscience. Or maybe I just let it go. Can I just let it go? Maybe I should do it now. Cast this with Omniscience. Yeah. Cast this with Omniscience. Do they respond by violin Thalia? So they put Thalia into play as expected. Alright, so I say okay, but now we should be able to win the game. So, is it using Cunning Wish ability? Yes. Let's get Rushing River. I think it's better to get Rushing River than to get a Disenchant. So I'll get Rushing River in my hand. And then I can go... And then I can go Rushing River, Bounce, whatever, like Protection Revoker, and whatever. It really doesn't matter. At this point, I win. So I'll cast this with Omniscience, sacrificing. So I choose 2 permanents. I'll choose Revoker and I'll choose Athalia. Yeah, whatever. I can choose Caracas. Oh, I can't. No land. All right, doesn't matter. I'll choose Revoker and I'll choose Athalia. And I'll pay 1 and I'll sacrifice a permanent. Now I can't attack me and I'll just get... They'll just get attacked with Emrakul, because even if they Caracas, I'll just get it back and take another turn and attack. So there was a little bit of going on, you know, a little bit of a little interaction, because mono white, death and taxes, why not having counters? It's always pretty annoying for this deck. Sure, Omniscience helps it a lot. Having Omniscience helps a lot the matchup. All right, and they concede. This was a 15 minutes game, but it was not that easy. Not that easy. Okay, so I think I want Monster Mentor, because that usually if you just board out Plow, I would assume. I can just cut the fairy. The static ability doesn't matter, and the bounce ability I think is just too expensive. And yeah, I think I like the deck as it is. I'm gonna keep it Narset. Spell Pierce is interesting. Maybe I should cut some Spell Pierces, because I want to draw, so I can't counter Vial. Yeah, maybe just Teferi just bouncing something is better than Spell Pierce, not countering much. So yeah, let's go with this. Alright, we returned all the cards to the sideboard, because that's a very hard thing to remember. For example, with Karn nowadays, I always count my sideboard after game one. Like, you know, it's just there's always 14 cards, like you always forget some cards, like, you're always like, oh, what should I, I was playing Vintage with Karn, and like right now it's the same, we had 2 cards that we took from the sideboard, so remember to do this. Alright, so they go pick the needle, naming Teferi Time Raveler. That's a bold strategy. Okay, we should win now. I mean, unless our opponent does something, put into play like something. Yeah, because simply to play a Thalia, it's annoying. But then I still have an Omniscience. And that's why I got an island, so they can't wasteland it. Alright, I got a Palace Jailer. They can't do that. Sure, to become the monarch. What am I gonna do here? Do I wanna go impulse first? Yeah, I'm gonna go impulse first. And I find the brainstorm. So double brainstorm is not necessarily the best thing. So let's cast illuminations. Find an intuition, that should win me the game. So get three cunning wishes. Play a Cunning Wish. Get Firemind Foresight. And then with Firemind Foresight, I'm going to... And then with Firemind Foresight... Yeah, this is Legacy, guys. Is it fun? Is it fun or it isn't? Yeah, sometimes it's like this. I mean... The fact that unfair decks exist, I think it's very healthy for the format because the answers are very good. If the answer weren't as good, then the unhealthy format would not make the format fun. Now, I really hope my opponent at least f6. If they don't want to concede, it's fine, but at least please f6. Don't make me wait while I'm comboing off. And the ways to win is... He's gonna reach his ability. He's gonna reach his ability. Yes. Sorry, I had to read it. So I'm gonna go for Mind Foresight. And then I'll cast it with Omniscience. I'm gonna get Cunning Wish, Impulse, Brainstorm. And then what happens is you go like Cunning Wish. I mean, you can just go for a. I'm just gonna do it. I'm gonna do it fast. Is there a. No, there isn't. Yeah. I mean, there's a fast way if you just put a Ledram Recall in your sideboard, but I didn't do it just because I wanted to do the Ledram. Just because it's like one slot in the sideboard, and usually people just concede. Like, you have to win now with Release the Ends if your opponent did not concede, which is fine. They can do that. So the way you win now is casting Impulse, getting whatever. It's going to be fine. I get a 3-drop just because it's a 3-drop. I guess not having, so I can get intuition. All right, let's play this. I was looking for board of the 3-drop on top of my deck. All right, I guess I have to risk it. I don't know, maybe I should really have a Dumb Recalling in my sideboard. Because usually, like, you play your brainstorms, your ponder and such, and then you just, and then you just win with like a Jamri with like Release the Ends. But it might just be that I don't find anything now. So I'm gonna go ponder. Looking for that 10 drop or whatever. Alright. I mean, I only have a 3-drop on top. I could have just played Mentor in the meanwhile. Alright, so let's put a Narset on top. I could actually play Narset. That's risky, because I could fizzle, but I could just play Mentor now. Oh my god, all the time here, what's happening? Alright, so I'm gonna just do this. I should have played Mentor immediately. I would have made a lot of tokens, at least. I mean, it's turn one. Yeah, I'm actually gonna do that. I'm gonna play Mentor. I'm gonna play Narset. It's funny that, you know, this fight, that I'm just going off, but it's not really going off. Because, I mean, I'm just looking for Omniscience to have the guarantee win. Alright, so I'm gonna cast another Narset, I guess. Our opponent not conceding is funny. Okay, so I'm gonna take Show and Tell. It doesn't do anything. Then I'm gonna cast Brainstorm. Okay. Alright, if I only lands, that's fine. I'm going to put this on top. And then I'll play Cunning Wish. Then I'll take. Yes. Then I'll take release the ants, and then just hope they don't have a 3-drop on top of their deck, or we would clash. Which is funny, but that could just happen. I could just get Intuition and dirtle around a little bit more, like that 3 cantrips, but that would just give me a cantrip, it's not that many. So he's gonna get release the ants and hope it works. Even if it doesn't work, I mean, they don't have much going on. So now, what's happening now is just that I'm clashing for a bunch until they find the 3-drop. Like, I was just looking for a better... I could lose this game, honestly. Like, now it's just a clash, so they find Caracas. I have to leave this on top. So they're gonna put the Caracas to the bottom. Alright, I concede, but it wasn't really win over. Like, it wasn't really game over, because I go release the ants, okay? What happens is, they raise the clash ability means that they can put to the bottom the Caracas. So I put bottom the Caracas, then I get release the ants back in my hand, I play release the ants, and at some point I find a 3-drop, and I just lose the clash, okay? And, you know, I just pass the turn, which is like, you know, a pretty big board and etc. But it was not over. I have an Omniscience and an Narset, so I'm gonna win, but it's funny, because the opponent just went, you know, all the way up, and now they decide to concede. Alright, I hope this was a cool game, cool round one. Yeah, you could put a Jammer's Call in this deck to just make it faster, but I just think that it's a kind of a waste of a slot in the sideboard, and I just think it's fine to have just Fireman Foresight and release the ends. And yeah, this was the win. Let's go back to round number 2. And round number 2, we're on the play once again. And sure, there's not a turn 1 kill. It's very far from it. Let's say thanks GL to our opponent, and let's go. I'm gonna go Island Pass. I could go Island Ponder, but I don't know. I kind of feel like leaving up spell appears is relevant in a lot of matchups. Like Aether Vial, turn 1 Chalice, Straight Rate, a combo deck. I don't know. Alright, Watery Grave. So this looks like Death Shadow, which is an awful matchup. Death Shadow eats all this combo deck for breakfast. Alright, let's go Ponder. The Stubborn Denial me, I'm not that unhappy. I mean, I'm fine. Alright, what do we got? We got a Mentor, which isn't as good as this post Cyber. I'm gonna draw that Narset. And just play Fetch Land and Pass. I don't think I want Mentor, just because I don't have basic planes, so I would need to get Tundra, and I definitely don't want to do that against a combo deck. Sorry, I meant against the Wasteland deck. Sometimes I just think about things and then say the wrong word. But luckily, sometimes just catch myself. Alright, so... Watery Grave and Thoughtseize. I'm gonna spell Pierce it. If they have a Stubborn Denial, whatever. It's gonna happen. I definitely don't wanna force off with a Thoughtseize. Alright. Not even a Daze. Interesting. At this point, I kinda just wanna jam an Narset here. Especially after this Lotus battle. Yeah. It's got a third island. I don't exactly know what's their hand. I'd just be a lot of Death Shadows and Gurmagangler. So let's cast an Narset, which is very strong against these blue decks. I think they have to force. And if they wow, they don't force. Great. Ooh, it's a lot of show and tells. Very nice, because it means that, you know, the other show and tells are to the bottom of the deck. And if I put in did have another Thoughtseize, I'm pretty sure I would have played it last turn, so I'm not playing around it. I'm just looking for, oh, what's this, nothing. I'm the Dark Bitter Blossom, alright, it's fine. couldn't have pictured a better play. Alright, I don't think this is a game of Monster Mentor. I think it's very likely an opponent has a removal spell, since, you know, they don't have much else. And there it is, Omniscience. We're going for the win here. To go Force, I'll go Force Speech Brainstorm. Then I have Omniscience, Cunning Wish. If they go Brainstorm, this is awkward if they go Brainstorm. So I'm playing around Daze here, so the only way that the Brainstorm is better than just a Force of Will is if they find like 2 Force of Will. and they have two blue cards in hand, which I don't think it's possible. She's gonna let this go, because if I just force this brainstorm and it was a bait, you know, I'm just, you know, in a bad spot. So the only way this brainstorm is better than an actual force of will. Well, I just concede. I didn't even want to see what we are up to. All right, game. So I guess we got this win because our opponent just drew a bad part of the deck. They might have drawn like this Member's Veil push or whatever, like Gurmic Anglers, and just die because of it. So I don't think Bozzeggio is good in this matchup, but despite they have encounters, they still have Wasteland. I mean, I don't know which versions they're playing. They've played Bitter Blossom, so they maybe play a controlled version, I don't know. I definitely want Teferi and Mentor. I think this is a plan that I always want to have post-sideboard in these matchups. So what am I cutting, though? What am I cutting? I think all the Petals and Ancient Tubes and City of Traitors are actually pretty good, because they just, you know, turbo my thing. Maybe just trimming combo. Maybe just trimming my combo. I don't know if this is right or wrong. This might not be right. You know, guys, this might not be right. Don't trust me on here, but I'm just trying new things. And since I'm having three tree drops, I think it's fine if I just trim on these. And I'm still having three because I still have Intuition in my deck and in the sideboard to get with Cunning Wish. But let's just see how this works. This is basically a three of decks, but like a Yu-Gi-Oh deck. I think I remember that Yu-Gi-Oh is a three maximum. I'm not even sure about that. I mean, we do have four of, so it's just a bad joke probably. All right, let's get back to game number two. Yes, that's fine. Maybe I should have boarded out one Ancient Tube. I don't know. Not sure. Because again, they could play Delver, or they could also play the control version. Alright. This end is very land heavy, but I don't think you can mulligan against the deck with... Oh, I should have boarded in Leyline. I forgot about it. Alright, guys, my apologies. I don't know why, but I forgot about it. I totally forgot about Leyline. I don't know what to cut, though. I mean, whatever. Let's hope to get this win. Gonna go Flooded Strand Pass. Yeah, I mean, it's taking it slow. Sure. Could just cut Spell Pierce. I could just cut some Spell Pierces. I'm not sure. Okay, they play a land and pass. I draw Force of Will. So I don't care about this Cunning Wish. I think I'm just playing Tundra here and passing. And next turn I can decide between Ancient Tomb and City of Traitors. This is bad in case they have Wasteland, but this deck plays a lot of, wow, they just have nothing there. Not even a Wasteland. Maybe they're not playing Wasteland. Like, if they play Cantrip here, they should definitely wait to play this land. Maybe they just don't play Wasteland then. Since they play this Polluted Delta immediately. I'm to Tarak. I'm gonna go Force. I'm gonna pitch Omniscience. I think the Cunning Wish is relevant. Let's see, if this is a Flaster Storm, it's annoying. Alright, it's good. It's good that it wasn't. Alright, I'm gonna go... Whatever, just end of turn. Fetch. I'm gonna fetch no matter what, so might as well fetch end of turn. Let's play Ancient Tomb, and let's play Narset, the Parter of the Veil. And let's see, is this a Spell Pierce maybe? Because last turn I had 2 mana up, so they couldn't Spell Pierce me. Whereas now they can. And if they do, it's unfortunate, but it's gonna happen. Yep. Fortunately, I have 1 mana up, not 2. Yep, I'll waste that mana. 3 cards in hand. They have 3 cards in hand. Next turn I can go for Cunning Wish Intuition. Not sure if I'm gonna play Under Dates though. Ooh, I'm to Turak, leaving me with just Omniscience. That's pretty bad. Our best draw is probably just either a Planeswalker like Narset or Teferi, or just Mentor. And that's a pretty cool way of fighting the discard plan of my opponent. It's maybe a reason to not necessarily need a ley line. Okay, so they cast Ponder. And they do not shuffle, so that's not a great news. All right, Wasteland, again, take away the Tundra, then I can't cast my Mentor anymore. I mean, not anything of what I wanted to cast. All right, they decide to go towards that. All right, draw Mentor, which is good. Hopefully they don't have another Harm to Turok on top. Really, really wish I had that Ley Line in my deck. I mean, my hand, I guess. Doesn't have to be in your deck. Okay, I'm gonna go Brainstorm immediately. Alright. I think I'm just gonna do this. Yep. I'll play a land, just in case they aim to direct me, at least I have a land in play. And I don't have at all, I just basically put, I did hide the Mentor, just in case they go for a Discard spell. Now I'm not gonna play Under Daze, I just wanna get a token. If they have a Daze, they'll get me. If they have a Force of Will, they'll probably counter. If they don't have anything, I get a token with this Lotus Petal. So sometimes you just can't afford to play around stuff. Also, I'm going to upkeep Impulse because I don't want to draw Omniscience. Alright, it looks like a Daze to me. What is this? Two blue floating. Alright, yep. Now, I guess I'm just gonna draw it. I'm just gonna draw the Omniscience because the only plan is just to combo it off. So I have to draw the Omniscience. Then I have to, I don't know, just get very lucky, I guess. Alright, it puts me down to a 2-turn clock, so there's nothing I can do about this now. I believe. Yeah. Alright, I'll concede. Actually, one sec. Alright. If I had to stop in upkeep, draw Teferi, get a Teferi with this, and then draw land, maybe I could have survived. I don't think so, no. Then have nothing, they just replay the Death Shadow. Alright, so definitely in the ley lines now. I want to draw. What do I want to cut? Maybe I cut Intuition? I don't know what to cut. Can I cut Forces? This is awkward, right? I don't want to cut Spell Pierce because this counters Umpteturk very well. Let's just try to cut Force. Yeah, I mean, I'm experimenting. So yeah, let's experiment these things. Okay, so we submit this, and let's go on the play for game number 3. Do we open the ley line, please? We don't. I'm gonna keep this hand. Hopefully I never draw ley line. I probably will. Because that's the thing with ley line. But, on the other hand, we can cast ley line this time around, because we do have Tundras. Not that ley line are casted, it's usually good enough, because the ley line is needed early game, it's not needed late game. Alright, so they play Straight Rate. Sorry, they cycle Straight Rate. And this Philip Thoughts isn't gonna spell Pierce. And they might have now changed that configuration after seeing my Mentors. So maybe I could have just been more combo only main deck. Sorry, game 3. Alright, let's go Island Pierce there. Next turn, I could go like Ancient Tomb Petal Teferi to play around Daze. Alright, I got Daze. I could have maybe played the Petal, I don't know. Yeah, maybe I should have played the Petal for situations like this. I kind of always want to slow roll the Petal, but, you know, sometimes you just make them not play Daze. It's quite relevant. Alright, so I take my Teferi and they pass. I draw Narset, that's great. Now I don't even need to play around Daze because they don't have lands anymore. So I'm just gonna get a... Did I get a Tundra? Yeah, I guess I get a Tundra. I do have a lot of, you know, I have like 5 white cards in my deck. Since I'm gonna use this Petal, so might as well just get a Tundra. If they have the Wasteland, that's fine. I mean, I still have Ancient Tomb and Island to play Show and Tell. All right. Four speech brainstorm. So they have 4 cards and then 1 it's a land, so they don't have that many cards. We also don't have anything left. We also don't have anything left. We do have a lot of 3 drops in our deck that are very good right now. Like 3 Show and Tell are very good. 3 Mentor, 1 Narset, 2 Teferis. And those are just, you know, Show and Tell used not to be like this. Or Emrakul. That's also pretty expensive card. A little bit too expensive, I would say.
Now having, you know, one less show attack is obviously awful, because all you want to look like, if you draw show attack, you just win the game. There's a big difference between, you know, a Teferi and the Narset and a show attack right now. So, you know, boarding it out is kind of awkward, especially against a combo deck. But they can also just go for, discard plus surgical. Sometimes that happens a lot. And now we have three mentor to beat that plan. Let's say I had a mentor in hand, you know, to play this turn. They got Wasteland. They go towards Ancient Tomb, which makes sense. And do they play also Gurmagangler? Looks like it. Yeah, but then again, this matchup is very favorable for the blue-black shadow deck. They have literally everything a combo deck is afraid of. Counters, Discard spell, cheap pressures in Delver, Gurmagang, Death Shadow. It's just a nightmare matchup. And you know, when I was playing Death Shadow a lot, there was a bunch of Reanimator and Adnaz and Tendrils and Show and Tell. Those were like a very easy matchup. The problem is that I gave up playing it because there was a lot of blue white, and that's just a nightmare matchup. Right now, blue white is very popular, both Stoneforge Mystic and Miracles, and I just, you know, that matchup was bad, so I gave up playing the blue-black shadow deck. But, you know, this matchup is very good for them. Too bad for us. We did steal the first game, but I think that's just because they just drew the bad part of their deck. Let's try it again. It's not going to be the greatest. This is just like a 4-mana impulse game, 4-5 life if sticks. Which does. Very nice. Okay, can I get a Show and Tell, please? I can't get a Cunning Wish, which in a lot of turns will be a Show and Tell. This Cunning Wish can turn into an Intuition, and that Intuition can turn into Show and Tell. But in the meanwhile, our opponent will have a lot of untap steps, a lot of draw steps, and, you know, just all the empty turrets in the world. Which is happening right now, looks like. I could still draw Mentor and just run away with the game with it, which is, you know, a possibility. Interesting. So they discard a Cunning Wish. Do they have a plan for my eventual Show and Tell top deck? Hopefully not. Come on, let's draw Show and Tell. No, it's very far away from Show and Tell. If they took the Cunning Wish there, I guess Show and Tell for Emrakul is very similar to Show and Tell for Omniscience for Emrakul. Alright, it's pretty boring, you know, once you hit the spot where, like, you just have to wait your opponent to kill or you to top deck. Alright, that's a ley line. Yeah, I mean, I just have one more draw step. If this was real life, I would just ask, do you have a Flusser Storm? I mean, I wouldn't do it, but in testing, I would do. Do you have a Flusser Storm? Do you have, like, a Force of Will? You know, if you don't. I just concede. If you do, I just concede. Alright, I'm on 2 life. Do I draw Show and Tell? There's no possible draws to get out of this, and I'll... I guess there is. I could go Ponder into Brainstorming into... yeah. Could Ponder into Brainstorming into City of Traders and Show and Tell. But if I'm thinking about this, I'm gonna concede, because if they think about this, means that they have it. So, Olimen wins the match, and Nyorigranda loses the match. We're at 1-1, let's head up to round number 3, but before that, this is ChannelFireball.com. Please head to their website if you are interested in buying any Magic cards, or even if you want to trade with them. Remember, it's 30% store credit bonus. And this is round number 3. This time we're in the draw. And we got a good hand. This could be a turn 1. No, I can't. There's no way I can turn 1 kill them. I can throw a Show and Tell them, but I guess if I draw like Emrakul, I could go turn 1 Emrakul. It was cool to have Seed of Traitor's Lotus spell, either if Blood Moon or Show and Tell along with it. It's a pretty good draw. It's a pretty good start. I'll put him on against the 6. Squad to the top, and don't really want to crack their Polluted Delta. Boston Mar, I guess. Alright, I'm gonna go Island and pass. Playing Petal now, game 1. Could you just give your opponent information that you're a combo deck, and you don't want to give them that those information. Let's say they have a I don't know, would they decide between playing turn 2 Amtuturak or turn 2 like Sylvan Library or whatever.
they maybe go for Civil Labyrinth and they just kill them, you know? There's just a lot of uncertainty about just, you know, just playing Fetch Land Go in the unknown format. Alright, what did they do? A Dark Ritual, ooh. Alright, so I could just Spell Pierce this to shut this off. Or I could just let them do their thing, and then, like, countering the other thing. They just basically, like, get card advantage from the Dark Ritual. Because what happens is, now I'm probably just gonna Spell Pierce this. Because if they have another land, they just go, like, land next turn, like, land and tomb. Then, you know, you might just... We might just not end up using the Spell Pierce anymore. So let's say they go in tomb now. I don't know. Maybe I should have waited. Okay, Faithless Looting. I'm just gonna let him do this now. I don't wanna pitch my brainstorm to the Force of Will. And that's awkward because like I really wanna go show Intel for Omniscience. Alright, this card a Grazer Brand. So now they maybe don't have a if I draw like a good card. Come on, let's draw a good card. Alright, let's go brainstorm. I can still go off with Cedar Trader's Battle if I draw well. Which is not the case. Alright, what do I want to shuffle away? I kinda wanna keep all these blue cards around. I think I just wanna get rid of Petal and City of Traitors and just play land and pass. Cause I don't like next turn I could just go land Narset or land Show and Tell if I draw. It's honestly just Emrakul. Alright. Reanimate, yeah, can't let it resolve, so. Gonna go Force. And let's hope they don't have another reanimation card this turn, or I need to. I don't know. There could have been some consideration for just countering the Faithless Looting, but then it might just be that they don't have a payoff there. Alright, what do I draw? Tundra. Okay, I'll play Tundra Narset here. Looking for, so I don't think they have a reanimation card, or they would have definitely played this turn. So I'm definitely looking for just a combo now. Alright, I think I prefer Spell Pierce over the other, sorry, Ponder over the other choices. Like if I have two blue, two force with something, I'll force with Ponder. And if I just untap next turn, I'm happy I have Ponder over Spell Pierce. My opponent had three lands, they could have had a fourth one even. So the Spell Pierce does not counter much. So they just are flooded. They don't even flashback Faithless Looting. I wonder why. Maybe they just forgot about it. Okay, so now we have a decision. Do we Narset first or we Ponder first? I think I went on Narset first. Looking for Omniscience. I get an Teferi, but what do I do even with Teferi? I don't do anything with Teferi. I'm just going to get probably Impulse. Because all I want to do here is dig deeper to find that Omniscience. I find an Emrakul. Showing that Emrakul though might not be the best. Might not be the best. If they go like Grisabrand, can they go Grisabrand though? They can go Grisabrand. So if you go Show and Tell, you put Emrakul in play, but they put, you don't know. They could put a Grisabrand in play. And you could just lose. So I think I have to shuffle these. I think I'm in a good position here. If I just, alright, there it is. If I just wait, like, next, like, this turn I could just play another Ponder and end of turn Impulse, you know? So, I think I'm fine in just going off now. Because, alright, if they have Grazerbrand, I see a lot of cards here. It's very likely that I just hit whatever I want to hit and just win with it. And also, if they don't have Grazerbrand, they just have Omniscience in play, I just cast Force of Will for free and etc. Alright, go Chancellor Arc. Actually, Grisabrand wasn't even good, because there's a Narset. So if I go for Emrakul there, they have a Grisabrand, but they can draw extra cards, and they can't attack me, my Narset, because they have Emrakul. So I should have definitely gone for the other line. I might lose now, whereas I could have easily won had I had the other one. So, okay, I maybe made a mistake here. I think I should have gone for Emrakul there. Now I lose the Narset. Remember, Chancellor says whenever an opponent casts a spell, counter it unless that player plays one. So now, either they attack me or kill Narset, probably just kill Narset so that they can reanimate Grisabrand and do something with it. Or I just flashback. I mean, I can't force a fill now.
Because if Force of Will gets countered. Even if I paid for free with Omniscience, you know? So, yeah, I definitely got screwed by the show and tell there. Which I shouldn't have been if I had an Emrakul in play. It wouldn't be like, there was no play, there was no way my opponent, I guess they could have had like a, what's called the Tired Spout Tyrant. Alright, this card, a land and a two. Do they also have a reanimate? Land, do they have a reanimation card? Looks like they do. Oh, and I'm gonna lose this game. Yeah, alright, they got a Grisa brand. Sure. I can draw 14 now. Yeah, I managed to lose this game. This was rough. This was very rough. I completely forgot about Narset shutting off the Grazer Brand. I mean, I'm still gonna play it out because opponent is not gonna win this turn. I can just top the Emrakul next turn. Just have 6 here. Pretty sad we have the missions to play. I can't play anything because of Chancellor. Alright, I have 12 cards in hand. They could maybe just... so if they have... Star of Insanity, that's probably the best thing they can reanimate. If they have Tazpout Tyrant, that's the second thing... The second best thing that they can reanimate. I guess Tazpout Tyrant is the best, actually. No, sorry. But they shouldn't have it, because... You know, they would have reanimated and then cast Unmask to just bounce my Omniscience. Yeah, it's okay. We learned that. I'm not used to playing Narset still in Legacy. I have not played Narset too much in Legacy. I did play her a while in Standard, and I know that, you know, Teferi, Time Raveler doesn't work, or Hydroid Crisis don't work, but in Legacy I have not had the Trunam Nemesis versus Grazer Brand interaction. I mean, I might have had, but I just forgot about it, I guess. Okay, so they discard my whole hand, but I can still draw Emrakul and be in a, I think, reasonable spot. Alright, I go to discard. Okay, can we draw Emrakul? They have Ashen Raider now to reanimate if I get Emrakul. Emrakul? Emrakul? Alright, good game. Good game. I did cut all the graveyard hate. Like, literally all the graveyard hate. There was a bunch of ley lineups off the board. I just cut them all. I was like, yeah, I'm not gonna play against black. I'm not going to play against Reanimator, I feel. And then I ended up playing it. Alright, so I want Ley Line. I'm going to board out Minister Mentor. I'm probably just... I guess Teferi can bounce a creature, but I don't think it's going to be that likely. I think Narset is actually fine to use Dix for the combo once we hit the counters for the early stage. Yeah, I think this is it. And we play first. We have a ley line, which makes so that they can't discard my cards. Unfortunately, it's not a black ley line, it's a white ley line. So I'm gonna keep the Spell Pierce 4 and Entomb, I guess. We do a pretty... I mean, this is fine. This is definitely good. Like, once you have ley line, you shut off older Thoughtseize, Cabal Therapy, whatever they want to throw at you. And they sometimes just rely a lot on those whenever they keep their hand. Alright, that's a good card. I'll probably just play Ancient. Like, I don't care about my life totals. I can just play Intuition end of turn. I'll probably just play Impulse no matter what, but just giving the option of either going Cunning Wish or Intuition, I think I want to. There's no Surgical Extraction in my sideboard. There used to be, but I cut that as well. I just cut all the graveyard hate. Alright, is that a... Entomb? It is. Alright, let's go Spell Pierce then. You can't let the Entomb resolve. I think Faithless Looting is fine to let resolve because they might just not have a Grisa Brand in their hand. Whereas Entomb is just guaranteed that I get Grisa Brand in a graveyard. And then they have, like, you know, 12 reanimation card or something like that. Okay, I'm passing again. I don't want to go hard cast ley line. I don't think it matters much. I could even go Cunning Wish for Flusterstorm now if our opponent goes like Entomb. Alright, they go Thoughtseize on themselves. Yeah, I think I'm actually gonna go Cunning Wish for Flusterstorm Storm here. Yeah, it's very unfortunate that I don't have a surgical. Yeah, let's go Cunning Wish. They could pay for the Flusterstorm if they have a Dark Ritual. That'd be awkward. But that would happen. I didn't know they would be... That would just be topped out and I might just go for like... I don't know. Do they have Dark Ritual? No, they don't. That's good. They could also just Cobalt Therapy themselves. Alright, second land, and they pass. Okay. I draw Ponder, I'm gonna play it. Play Ponder before playing Intuition, because if there's just one good card only. This is strange. Because Cunning Wish is not bad, because can't get... It's just a combo card. It's just like the win con. Like, once you assemble the things, you need Cunning Wish. So I think I'm just gonna draw Cunning Wish here and just pass the turn. And then I'll decide if I want to end of turn do like intuitions for show and tell or something. I might just... Alright, I'll therapy them again and I don't think I can... I could go intuition for Force of Will. Yeah, if I had a surgical... This game would have been so much easier. So much easier. Just thinking about it. I think I'm just gonna go for Force of Will here. It's pretty funny, if your opponent is Leyline, you can't even cast Intuition, because you have to target your opponent. So I'm gonna get Forces here, and just force that Cabal Therapy. Like, they clearly drew this turn, so I just want to keep them off putting creatures in their graveyard. Because once they do, I don't think I can stop the rest of their hand. Alright, what do we think is worse? I think Cunning Wish is worse than Impulse. I can just play Impulse next to our main phase and just, you know... At worst, got a cantrip. The very worst, get a cantrip. And mana floating now, so I'm just gonna Cunning Wish. Go get Intuition, I guess. There's not much else I can get. You could Artcast Fireman Foresight in a blue-red deck, but nothing other than this since we don't have access to red. So basically, I think I'm dead to a lot of stuff here. Pitless Looting is one of them. Alright. I did try to keep them away of reanimating Razor Brand, but I don't think I can. And once again, I should definitely put at least a Surgical Extraction in my deck. Like, if I don't want to put Leyline of the Void, which is fine. Alright, didn't even have that much, they just had a Chancellor. Which, I mean, it's gonna give me a 2-turn clock. Let's see if at least they have a reanimation card. Or that'd be funny, because I really fight a lot the reanimation package. Alright, so what I'm looking for here is definitely not land, and now I don't think that I can get out of this. It's a good go for intuition, but even if I draw something else next time, I guess I can draw show and tell. And Emrakul. So I'm gonna go intuition for show and tell, and then Emrakul. And then I can draw Emrakul and just play Emrakul, put it into play Emrakul. Because I don't think they upgrade a brand in hand, or they would discard it. I have 2 turns, I guess. Getting Leyline in play kind of means that I don't get, like, it's very good. So I think this matchup can get improved a lot by just first thing first playing well, not like we did in the first game. And second by having a Surgical Extraction in your sideboard.
Like turn two, kindly wish for surgical. It's like fine. It's doable. All right, I'm gonna concede here. All right, good game. Good game, Reanimator. We'll be back for round number four. Round number four with Omnitell. All right, I'm just one omniscience away from winning on turn two if we don't get interaction. We can't play any Teferi or Narset on turn two though without petals. Wow, do we go wasteland? Okay. Just gonna get my Tundra at wasteland, that's fine. I have a second one. And if the wasteland needs this one as well, I'm gonna brainstorm. So really need to get either a omniscience or an island. Alright. No wasteland at least, so that's good news. Do I still wanna brainstorm end of turn? I think I will. I just don't wanna play turn two Seed of Traitors. Ah, yes, I do have to. Yes, much. No, there's not much I can do about it. I think I'm just gonna try and play Show and Tell turn two. Trying to bait a counter magic. Because, yeah, I mean, I don't have much. And I mean, it's just Show and Tell resolves and just put into play a thing, it's annoying. But I think all I have right now is just Show and Tells. So I just have to jam them and hope they resolve. Steam vents. Okay. Opponents on a budget on Magic Online, but Volcanic Island isn't even expensive on Magic Online. Okay. So we used our, so basically what happened here is that you have to use your Show and Tell as a threat, basically. So I don't mind just running another Show until next turn. Or did it brainstorm to find a wasteland? They do wasteland me. Ah, I don't think I can get out of this. Next turn I could consider just going Show until once again. Maybe they just concede like the other opponent did earlier. Okay. Event is back. Alright, I'm just gonna go Show and Tell again. They have seven cards in a blue deck. It's very likely that they just have an answer, or so they're just shocked. I don't mind just trading resources here. Oh, please don't let it resolve. Please don't let it resolve. Usually, this is a good sign for your spell to resolve. All right, the force, nice. Force, peach, force, wow, okay. So we're clearing our way for the third Show and Tell. Looks like our opponent's playing Canadian, so they shouldn't discard our cards. Because they have a Mystery Enforced and a Steam Vents. A Watery Grave, so they have, what, Death Shadow now? Mystery Enforced. Okay, so that's a 1-1, fair enough. So they had a plan, it's not that they were playing budget. I did not see Wasteland, Steam Vents, and Mystery Enforced, Steam Vents, and the other card together. Okay, so I think this time the Show and Tell will resolve. So I'm just gonna go for Ponder, looking for an Omniscience here. Oh, find a lot of them. Okay, and this time I'm gonna go Show and Tell again. I could go Cunning Wish. No, I think I'm gonna go Show and Tell. Like, last turn opponent went Force by Pitch Force after going Brainstorm, so I think they just don't have an answer for it. Four cards, what do they have? They have like Stubborn Denial or whatever, yeah. I mean, I'm super happy on how this game went. And I hope it was I hope it was a cool lesson for you guys. All right. Now we just have to do the thing that takes a while, but this time we're never gonna fizzle because we have a lot of different stuff. While I say this time we're never gonna fizzle, we could easily still fizzle because it's still part of the deck, but all I wanna do here is finding well, I guess I should have just drawn the top cards with my, because there was an Omniscience on top of my deck. Alright, whatever. I'm gonna get... So, Force of Will is a 5-drop, but they will eventually find a 5-drop, so I'm just rather gonna get Narset here. And, so, what do I want to find here? It's funny, because it takes a while to go off. I'm gonna go Impulse. Alright, Teferi. Still a pretty good one, I think. I mean, Force of Will costs 5, eventually... They're on 12, so I have to repeat this thing. So they have 2 5-drop. Yeah, no, 5-drop should be fine. I mean, we're still looking to find... the bigger one. Oh, wait! I know the line now. Sorry. I don't know why I missed it. Okay, it's gonna be okay. So I go Cunning Wish, because we have an extra Cunning Wish. So I can go Cunning Wish for Intuition. Yeah, we're never gonna fizzle now. We go Cunning Wish for Intuition. Then... Intuition for 3 Omniscience. Now we're gonna fizzle, yes. Omniscience. Done. Then I go Brainstorm and then I go Release the Ants. And then we'll be done. Brainstorm. Put on top land and Omniscience, Cunning Wish. Yes. Okay, release the ants and then let's shoot them. Top. And then we win. So this was cool. This was, I think, a pretty good showing off on how you can use your show and tell as threats to bait your opponent counter magic. And then eventually just resolve yours. You know, we still had to find that show and tell, but we did, and we succeeded. So I'm very happy on how this game went. Now I'm gonna board in Mentor for what? So my opponent's playing Death Shadow, though they're playing a weird version. I don't think they're playing Empty Turok, so I don't think I want Leyline just for Thoughtseize. Yeah, I think I'll do something like this. Game number 2 against, I don't know, was that Grixis Death Shadow? Okay, this is a good hand. Yeah. I like Mentor in this matchup. Especially since they're not expecting it. I mean, I could still live in Lightning Bolt. Because, like, it's different than, like, Blue Black Shadow definitely boards out, like, Dismember and Fatal Push or whatever they have. Whereas Liquid Lightning Bolt could keep in Lightning Bolt. But if they don't, Monastery Mentor just takes over the game. Monastery Mentor, a restricted card in Vintage indeed. Okay, start off with a Thoughtseize that's gonna reveal the Jig. As they say, the Jig is up. And they just discard immediately. They're just not about my Jig. Alright, I'm gonna go Island Go. And I'm gonna go probably just Island Go again. I don't really wanna ponder for much now. Sure, I would like to draw spells, but I also... I don't mind to just make sure that my opponent doesn't do much. And I don't mind your spell piercing the ponder. So sure, you know, I could spell pierce something else, but the later the game goes, the worse spell pierce gets. So I don't mind just cashing in my 2-for-1. Sorry, my 1-for-1. Of course, it's not a 2-for-1, it's just a counter magic. Okay, what's next? More ponders? Alright, this different ponder. Still, same effect. And next turn, depends on what I draw, but okay, what are they doing with the ponder? They don't shuffle. All right, draw Lotus Petal. I'm just gonna go land go, I think. If they wanna daze my Impulse, I'm happy. I don't wanna show them that I have a Lotus Petal because they don't know about it.
And if they want to Thoughtseize me, that's gonna be fine. Alright, Delver Secrets. That's definitely a threat. But it's better than Death Shadow. Maybe not. I don't know. Let's go get... I guess I can get Tundra. I do have a lot of white card in my deck. And they don't have a land, I think.
So I'm gonna go Impulse.
And I'm just gonna take Mentor now. Them discarding Mentor on turn one kind of makes me think that they don't have any answer. So I'm just gonna go for Seed of Traitors Mentor here. Show and tell, yeah. So I can just double attack my opponent on different sides here. The Mentor side and the Show and Tell side. If they have a Lightning Bolt, it's not great. I mean, I still make a 1-1, which could attack them. They're on 12. They don't have a Death Shadow, they would have played it. Okay, they go Force. Interesting. Switching Spell Pierce. Check out this non-creature spell over here. All right, then let's go look for, our combo. I could have played Petal. I guess they can't have Daze. If they had Daze, they would have probably played it. Alright, my P2 just passed the turn now. So, now we have your Show and Tell, and the opponent has just one card in hand. And we're on 19, so we do have a lot of good draws here, I think. Okay. So they're on 9, because they pitched, Alright, they don't flip. They find a Wasteland, though, so I can't cast... I guess a Petal, so I can't cast literally everything I have. I want. And what else? Oh, Dreadlord Arcanist. That works very well with Thoughtseize as well. Alright, so I need to just find my Omniscience now. Or Emrakul, I guess. And I find it. Very nice. Oh, actually, this is very bad. Oh, why did I do that? They have a Pyroblast in the graveyard. Alright, I kind of deserve the Shame Concession here. Even if it's too early, I think it's this is the Shame Concession time. Not that I would have been a good spot, opponent would have just Thoughtseize me with Dreadlord Arcanist. So yeah, very good, very well played by Dreadlord Arcanist there. And do I want to cut my Mentor now that my opponent knows about them? I don't think so. I think they're still pretty good. Do I want to do anything with my Teferi? I don't think so. No, I think this is fine. Let's just submit this. Actually, maybe I'm keeping it. Maybe I'm boarding in the Teferi. Maybe I'm boarding the fair. Just overload on threes. I'm gonna cut like one Cunning Wish, one Intuition, and one Spell Pierce. Yeah, just overload on the good three drops. Someone will stick. Yeah, I think I like this. On the play, and sure, it's a keep. Gonna go with Land Ponder. Unfortunately, I can't play the Fairy turn one because I would need multiple auto spells. It would be good though. Alright, so what do we find? So what do we find is not bad, honestly. I think I can just go for Force, and if they go... Yeah, I think I like keeping the Force here. And also Emrakul is not the worst. And I'm gonna go Petal. Just in case I go Thoughtseize, I'm gonna go Force Speech Omniscience. Then I have Petal to pay for a Daze. And then I can just land at the Teferi with an Emrakul in hand so that basically any Show and Tell it's lethal. And the Teferi also buys a couple of turns if they go like a Delver or flip it or whatever. You know, in Legacy it's not that easy to attack. Okay, they go Underground Seek Go. Which means that it's possible that they just have a Spell Pierce for my Teferi. They can't have a Red Elemental Blast, though. This is interesting. But I think the top card is too bad that I don't want to go for Teferi this turn. I just want to pass the turn, and next turn I can play around Spell Pierce. And if they have Amphitorak, I have Force of Will, even though I don't think they have Amphitorak in their deck. And also now I want to play Polluted the Delta because of the land on top of my deck. Alright. Okay, that's fine. So I think they drew just a Steam Vance now. Or they would play turn one, I believe. Alright. So I'm gonna get Tundra? I don't think so. So if I get Tundra, no, I think I gotta get Tundra, honestly. Yeah, I'm gonna get Tundra. Because I don't have to craft a paddle this way. I'm gonna go Ancient Tomb Teferi. Paying two for paddle. And if they have like paddle dates, then I can force. I'm not sure if protecting this Teferi is that relevant, but I just think it's pretty good. Like if I put it, no, put it now as a Delver, alright? Let's say they flip it and attack Teferi. Yeah, maybe it just bounces Delver. Yeah, maybe it just bounces Delver if it resolves. Bounce the Delver if the Teferi resolves. Alright, I go for Spell Pierce. So we do pay. And then if they have days, I'm gonna go for speech. Okay, they don't. That's good. So they don't have any counter. I'm gonna bounce this just because if they I could even force the Delver here, guys. I'm gonna force the Delver actually. Just so that I keep around my Teferi. Alright, so I lose the Ancient Tomb? Yeah, I lose the Ancient Tomb. That's okay. And then they play Delver, they'll play Force. They can't fight me. Because they can't play instants. They could have like a Pyroblast. I mean, if they had Pyroblast, they would have played it, I think. Well, it happened like this. So they prefer having the option of drawing Thoughtseize over the one of drawing. Of drawing Red Amount of Blast. Not that the fairy does too much, but I'm gonna go Force Delver. Force Delver Secrets here. Pitching Omniscience. They might have, like, you know, the Death Shadow and Gurmagangler as threats, and they can't cast them right now. Alright, they go not shuffle, so that's, it can't be a good sign. Alright, what is this? Delver? Alright. It's Force. And now I'm looking for, I don't know. Alright, I can't force back or anything, so I just done. They made their land drop, so they have to pass the turn here. And they could go for Surgical, but... Okay, do I want to play Brainstorm? I guess I do. Okay. Is this lethal? Yes. I mean, I can put into play Show and Tell. That's almost lethal, right? I could also put into play a Omniscience, but because I have to put back two cards and they can't be land and pedal. I'm just gonna go for Emrakul. I don't think their deck can beat it. Sure, they can have a Liliana's Triumph or another Diabolic Edict, but I think I'm gonna take this slot, this pot now that I have, now that I'm protected by Teferi. So I'm just gonna go for it now. And you know, Delver decks usually don't beat Emrakul. Again, they could, but it's unlikely. So I think I'm gonna take the risk instead of just passing the turn with Teferi. That could kill Teferi and then have like a Force of Will for my Show and Tell, and then have nothing left. So I think this is better. Okay, another pass with Emrakul in play. Please don't have a Diabolic Edict or Liliana's Triumph. And we'll all be friends. And by that I mean I just win the game. Alright, and that's the win. This was a cool match. I'm not sure. So we pulled the trigger all out on this Teferi. And I think it was good. I think I was happy with it. And this was the match. So we're 2-2 as we get back for round number 5. This might be the first mulligan that we do, or this hand just doesn't do anything. And all I'm looking for is land drop, so I'm gonna just grind to the bottom of that ponder. Could have drawn that ponder because we just go island ponder. And then if I miss a land drop, I just go ponder again. But I just that's a classic Modo bug in the meanwhile. Which you scry to the bottom and you just draw the same cards. And you're fine with that because that's just how it is. And, you know, it's just a recurring joke, by the way. It's not a bug. Or at least, it's not proven to be a bug. It's just that whenever it happens, you point it out. And, you know, that just makes so that you remind it every time. But that's funny, because that happens quite a while. But that's the same thing in real life. You also sometimes, I also do that joke in real life as well. And just look at the bottom of the deck for fun. Whenever I play with friends, of course. I can't do that in a sanctioned event.
Alright, so I'm gonna get another island and play Ponder. I don't want whatever was on top. Looking for I guess lands. Yeah, I mean I like this. Three. I don't mind the fourth land, the third land next turn. Next turn I kinda wanna just play Impulse next turn. I should have probably just drawn Impulse, honestly, because if I have to make Force of Will, I will do that. But as it is, I don't want to play around Spell Piercer Daze, so I'm just going to delay the game for a while. I'll keep on taking damage, which, I mean, turn one Delver is the easier way for this matchup to, you know, for you to lose in this matchup. I'll play Island. I honestly don't want to play Petal, just because if this Spell Pierce my Impulse, it's not that big of a deal. Next turn I can go for tap for Teferi, bounce the Insect Aberration. Sure, they can bolt it. They can bolt the Teferi, but I'll gain some time in the meanwhile. Okay, they've only played one spell yet. They don't even play this Brainstorm that they have in their hand. Alright, they drew a land. Maybe they do it now? No, they don't. Okay, Impulse. And they just snap resolved it. Snap resolved. Okay, so kind of wish doesn't do anything. I mean, it could get intuition like 20,000 turns. I mean, not that Force of Will does much. I already have one. I'm just gonna get Cunning Wish, but not the happiest about it. So I'm gonna draw. I thought there was a Tundra on top of my deck, but apparently it isn't because I just played Impulse. So I draw a Show and Tell. And I guess I'll play it. I mean, is that a Spell Pierce? Would I play it on the Impulse? Maybe not. Maybe we should just play Teferi as a bait, but like, what do I do here? Like, Teferi is not even a bait, because they just bolted. I'll just play Show and Tell. And then force it. If they have it, they have it. And they go Spell Pierce. Alright. Yeah, I'll force it. Pitch. I guess I'll pitch Cunning Wish. I mean, the thing is that the longer this game goes, the worse it is, you know? And sure, you know, I could have played the land to play around Spell Pierce next turn, maybe. Or just not play Impulse there, just draw your Tundra. But I didn't have Show and Tell there. I just wanted to find Show and Tell. Like, the thing is, this is just a naturally bad matchup for, like, Show and Tell loses Delver. Like, it's been always like that, you know? And the reason why Delver decks are great is because they beat on combo while being, like, reasonable against other decks. Let's go Bolt end of turn? No, let's go Brainstorm, okay. Now, I mean, I can't just draw another Show and Tell. Like, you saw how to beat Delver earlier by drawing three Show and Tell to drain them away of counters. This game won, so they have a bunch of dead cards, hopefully, like Bolts and Chain Lightning and whatever. And Pyroblast, sorry, and Price of Progress, hopefully. But there's also Brainstorm to shuffle away those in case. So play against Blue-Red Delver. But again, this turn one Delver, it's definitely the name of the game. If it wasn't there, I would have had way more. All right, they could Bolt face. Do I have three Bolts? Yeah, so you can see, like, they had three Bolts there. So it was, you know, they could have just had nothing for that Show and Tell. If I had a land there, I would have probably won because I had mana to play Spell Pierce and they couldn't double counter me. Alright, good game. So, playing as Blue Red Delver, they still have Wasteland. The new Blue Red Delver still have Wasteland. So, basically, the possession are here only for miracles. So, I think I want the Fairy and I think I want Mentor. Actually, not. I don't think I want Mentor. They're definitely keeping Bolts. Definitely. Because if Grixis deck might cut, you know, because they have other cards. But Blue Red doesn't have that many cards to bring in. So, they're definitely keeping Bolts. So, we're gonna have the Fairy and call it a day. Okay, so on the play against the Blue-Red Delver, that's a keep. I'm gonna go Land Ponder with this Pollute Delta for looking for what? I'm basically just navigating this game in a very fair way. My hand is very slow, so I just cantrip my way to a perfect hand. Turn one Delver would be probably the worst thing to happen because
that we just put up a clock on this very slow hand. And remember, so the thing is that our opponent did not play Discard Spell, so they don't have like the Discard Spell plus Surgical Play. That's also why I boarded out Mentor. Or I like this a lot. I'm gonna draw Spell Pierce just because eventually, you know, on turn 4, I could go Show and Tell with Spell Pierce up. Alright, Alan Delver, unfortunately. And that's fine. So, there's a Brainstorm on top of my deck that I don't really want right now. All I'm looking for here is Omniscience, because I have the Show and Tell in my hand right now. Alright, come on, Delver, don't flip. There it is, Surgical Extraction. Wow. So basically means that, this Show and Tell has to resolve. If the Show and Tell does not resolve, I lose the game. It's not the best way to be in, but alright, I don't have a second land though. They kept six, and okay. So I'll go Impulse, I'll get Teferi. Starting to make them counter things. Like they don't have access to Red Elemental Blast right now, so I think it's better if I just jam. Sure, they can have literally anything, and I'll be fine with that. Or Brainstorm. It's interesting that they decided to not play Brainstorm in upkeep or main phase to just hit the land drop there. So I wonder what they have. If they didn't even have, maybe they have Flaster Storm. They wanted to leave mine on tap. Alright, unfortunately we hit the daze and we can't daze back because we don't have it. We have Spell Pierce, which is much worse in this case. So I think I'm gonna put them on Flaster Storm here, which is actually very annoying for us to beat. So Flaster Storm plus Surgical. Yeah, we needed the fairy to resolve. Alright, Wasteland. Okay. And yeah, they accept Aberration beating down. Right, this was a great draw if I had Omniscience in play in hand, sorry. So I'm gonna go for Brainstorm. I think I'm gonna go for it. Maybe. Because the thing is that I think they have Flaster Storm. Alright. So since they have Flaster Storm, I think I'm gonna go for Show and Tell. I don't have access to Spell Pierce right now, but next turn the Flaster Storm will just kill me, I think. Because that's the... You have to play around reads, okay? So what happened here was, I thought... So my opponent had an Island and a Brainstorm, and I decided not to main phase it nor upkeep it. So I think what they had was a very good card, because I didn't want to miss a land drop and not have that very good card up. And when we cast the Fairy, they didn't use it. They didn't use their Spell Pierce, they Brainstormed. So it means that it was a Flaster Storm. So now that my opponent wasn't up for Flaster Storm, I had to resolve the Show and Tell. Because if they just play their Island and don't play a single other thing, I might just lose the game because I need to hit the land, which I don't have on top of two cards in my deck. So I just had to hope they didn't have Force of Will. So again, you know, there was read to be done. Sure, they could have had Force of Will anyway and I would have lost no matter what. But I think I had to play for my read, and we got there. Okay, and yeah, this was a pretty good sideboarding, I think. So let's go to game round number 3. Okay, so we open a 7-card hand with just one land and can't embrace them as cantrip, but I think I'm still gonna keep. This deck plays a lot of mine in general, and I'm fine with this. Also, I don't really want a mulligan. I have 2 Show and Tell, you know, it's the name of the... Oh, once again, Delver turn 1. Delver turn 1 is definitely the best way to attack those combo decks. Because it doesn't interact with you, sure, but it is just a very good card. Alright, draw Ancient Doom, which was definitely a good draw. I could consider just jamming a Show and Tell turn 2, though that would play badly against Surgical. My opponent boarded in Surgical despite being a blue-red deck. I really dislike that. Who would have flipped with Flaster Storm? Like, Surgical is bad against Omnitell, because
you don't have Discard spell, so it's just a dead card. Like, it's gonna be a dead card, like, almost every game you're not losing. Sorry, or every game you're not already winning. Because you need to counter Show and Tell in order for the Surgical to be good. Unless you want Surgical like a Brainstorm or something, which is, like, not a good play. Okay, so I'm gonna go for Brainstorm end of turn. Because I plan on casting Show and Tell next turn. And I have two Brainstorm. Alright. It's fine. Yeah, as I said, I plan on going for Show and Tell here. I don't have a counter right now, so as I said earlier, I want to basically use this Show and Tell as counters, as like ways to put my opponent counter. Of course, if they have Surgical, I lose. Because I don't have any other win con, because I don't have Flaster Storm in my deck. Sorry, Monaster Mentor in my deck. Okay, so I get Flaster Stormed, and I was just hope they don't have Surgical, I guess, but I think I'm happy with this, because I don't have an easy way now, an easy way out now. Because at least now we got rid of that. Alright, so they have Surgical, and I think I can scoop up my cards. Yeah, that's fine. That's totally fine. I'm happy I didn't have Mentor. Because that's how we won game two. Okay, that's fine. Good game. Again, the Surgical play played out now, so, you know, I was just complaining about this. And, you know, it worked for them. I still encourage you not to Cyborg Surgical against Omnitell if you don't have black, but you're totally welcome to do that and win the game with it. All right, this was it. We went 2-3. I think I played very well in this league. There was a lot of cool games. We did make some mistake, of course, like when I played Omniscience into a Pyroblast or something in the graveyard. But this was cool. I'm not sure if, probably like this deck is maybe just not that good. So even if it gained something like Teferi, Narset, or Mentor, I mean, didn't gain Mentor, we just splashing Teferi, and eventually just splashing Mentor as well. This might not be, you know, as well as Sneaker Show, but it's definitely something new, and it's very important, I think, for this video that I do with the new card. So hope you enjoyed, and we'll be back for more video next time. Goodbye. And don't forget, this is ChannelFireball.com. There's a YouTube channel, so subscribe to that.